Qualifying is about to start here at the Autodromo di Monza for the Italian Grand Prix. The teams are about to head out onto the track any minute now. So then, Ant, it's another Grand Prix weekend, another exciting qualifying session ahead of us. What are you going to be looking out for over the next few minutes?
The first question is going to be who can avoid making mistakes. There isn't much margin for error in qualifying, and you have to bear in mind that the track conditions may have changed since practice, particularly as we've had a few support races in the meantime. If the brake bias settings, for example, don't take this into account, it's extremely easy to lock up a front wheel and cause a flat spot. Just like that, your lap's ruined, and you've wasted a set of tyres to boot.
第14站的 F108 Calendar 就会带我们来到 Monza Grand Prix 意大利 Grand Prix 在Monza跑的 这个场出了名是最高速的场地，严格来说其实是IndyCar的转右，还有一个事情，我们现在Qualifying 1我们会做一个Fastest Lap，就证明了，不过Tyre Guy发觉我们证明了我们其实是有战力的，在这个场，因为Williams的封阻就是低，因为它的Aero很差，Q2我们会又是做一个Fastest Lap，1.22.63的， 就会摆我们在Vettel和夏美顿后面，即代表其实除了Benz和发记之外，我们是很有机会拿到 Pole，第五，即是怎么都要有第五，因为有Q3，我们第一个 lap会做1分23.146， 很明显是差过我们 Q2的时间的， 我就会决定再做多一个 lap。 下一个 lap，我们就会现在快紧自己刚刚个 lap 大概1秒左右嘅冲线嘅时候1分22.313咧，就会摆我哋喺第三名。咁嚟到每次嘅 upgrade 时间啦，咁我哋上次嘅呢个 track 就搞掂咗啦，咁我哋下一次就会升呢个 front downforce
嘅。It's race day here in Italy once again. Monza, home to so many records. The smallest winning margin, for example. Do you remember in 1971, Peter Gethin beat Ronnie Peterson to the line by 1/100th of a second. There were 40 overtakes for the lead alone in 1965, and Kimi Raikkonen clocked a record top speed of 230 miles per hour here, just over a decade ago. So there's a lot to live up to then for all of our drivers today. With top speeds up to 215 miles per hour and an average lap speed of around 155 miles per hour, Monza's reputation as one of the fastest circuits in the sport is well earned. We have 11 corners on this 3.6 mile track, with the best overtaking chance coming into the heavy braking zone of the Turn 1 chicane. With me today, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Now, I want to ask you about Valtteri Bottas. That was a great win in the last race. Can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
It's always nice to come into a Grand Prix weekend on a high, but your expectations are based much more on your practice and qualifying runs. So it's the momentum from those sessions that they'll be hoping to carry into the race today.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Sebastian Vettel has a clear track ahead of him today. He starts in pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Cox, Raikkonen, Valtteri Bottas, and Verstappen, Ricciardo, Ocon, Perez, and Nico Hülkenberg, Sainz, Magnussen, Romain Grosjean, and Alonso, Van Dorn, Gasly, Charles Leclerc, and Brendan Hartley. Sirotkin and Marcus Ericsson rounds off the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
意大利 Grand Prix 的这个 Temple of Speed Monza, and it's lights out and away we go. 我们这个起步就很明显就比前面的 Lambo 差的，但就不是输很多。我们开始会有 Vettel 的气流食，我们慢慢追紧上去。夏美顿同阿 Vettel 会平排紧落去呢个头弯的时候呢， Raikkonen 就会冲咗出嚟嘅，就会上一个第三名啦。咁后面就撞咗一大堆嘢嘅时候咧 ，VSC 就会出咗嚟嘅。咁乱到咁，我唔知后面发生咩事啦。但我跌咗一个位嘅啫。系啦。 咁亦都唔出奇嘅。Monza 嘅头弯系出事出得多嘅，就算 AI 都系会炒嘅。咁如果你有睇到 GT 嘅呢、這个Top 24咧，你见到欧洲嗰边就头弯都炒得好犀利嘅。咁系啦，讲一讲背景先。咁呢一场我跑嘅时候咁啱就系以真实嘅呢个 Italian Grand Prix 完咗啦。咁我好嬲啊，咸美顿啦嗰阵。咁系啦，就你会研究到我点解会完全唔想俾咸美顿走嘅。咁 FS 而家就完啦，咁我哋再开始比赛啦。Return to racing speed， 咁我哋嚟到 Ascari 嘅时候咧，就会其实你系会睇到我哋部车同前面嘅单火石争几远嘅，佢哋明显拉开咗一个车位以上，再加埋佢哋而家有 slipstream 嘅 reckoning 会拉开咗至三个车位，但系我哋有嘅系 power， 我哋落紧去尾弯呢个 parabolica 嘅时候咧，一个 lay break 虽然话有少少入唔到 apex， 但系我哋个起优可以早啲嘅。咁我哋就會教翻個 engine mode 嗰度咧，就會而家跟翻阿 Raikkonen 後面就衝緊落去個頭彎嘅。咁係啦，暫時唔會有啲咩大事發生嘅，因為大家都冇事發，冇乜點做嘢。啱啱講完，而家阿 Vettel 就會想過，唔係阿夏美頓就想過阿 Vettel。咁而家阿夏美頓同阿 Vettel 平排緊落緊，出咗呢個頭彎啊，頭切 King 啊，就兩個平排緊落去呢個 Curve Grande 嘅內彎有阿 Vettel， 外彎係夏美頓。两个继续平排紧落去呢个第二次倾嘅刹车嘅时候会系咸美顿喺内弯嘅，咁啊 Vettel keep 得到佢部车喺咸美顿隔篱，佢会成功 keep 住佢呢个第一名啦，但系就会失咗速嘅 Raikkonen 就会想望一望啊 Hamilton 前面啦，但系佢发现冇嘅时候咧，佢会喺呢个 last move one 嗰度咧失咗速，俾前面走咗嘅，咁好在我收得次车，如果唔系我哋 front wing 又冇咗噶啦。咁系啦，冇事發生，一去 cut 到第五個 lap 咧。咁 Raikkonen 喺上一個 lap 就已經入咗 pit 噶啦。咁我哋而家就跟住阿 Vettel 同埋夏美頓入 pit 咧，就好齊全一齊 pit 得。後面見到啊，應該係 Force India 都入 pit 啦。咁我哋出翻嚟嘅時候，會啱啱好喺阿夏美頓前面。我哋會跳咗兩部車嘅喺呢個 pit stop 嘅時候。咁我哋出翻 pit 嘅時候，最緊要睇下 Raikkonen 喺邊。佢哋而家就喺我隔離。冲紧上去，见到 Gasly 同 Ericsson 同埋 Van Dorn 喺度斗紧，阿 Raikkonen 就喺我后面。咁我哋会留一留位俾 Raikkonen 嘅，好用啊 Raikkonen， 同现实一样好鬼用啊 Raikkonen。咁我会让一让位俾佢噶啦。咁系啦，虽然话我 Cover Ground 可以踩行佢啊，但系到第二次倾我反而仲惊，咁我决定留一留喺佢后面一阵先咧，咁悭一悭油，睇下后期会唔会 strike 翻上咧。咁嚟到第二次傾嘅時候 ，Raikkonen 會 lock 咗胎啦，咁啊咸美頓就會喺我哋嘅左邊啦。佢 cut 咗關地，其實已經抽咗一陣嘅，但係我決定唔理佢啦，決定守住佢喺後面啦。咁佢喺 last move one 嘅時候靠住佢嘅 downforce 過我哋啦，咁佢冇俾夠位我，就唔小心撞到佢尾胎嘅。咁然之後咧 ，last move two 嘅時候佢會爬咗我哋頭，但係我哋有 power， 我哋有 DLS， 咁我哋而家較高咗個 ELS deployment， 就會諗住 Ascari 過翻佢。我哋而家就喺佢左邊喺橋底嗰度已經過咗阿夏美頓㗎。但留翻俾留翻一部車嘅位俾佢咧，咁我哋阿 Scary 嗰度可以 keep 住喺呢個內彎度好確定咁喺夏美頓前面翻咗嚟。咁因為我哋逼咗佢少少啦，咁 AI 嘅關係咧，佢會 fall back 一陣嘅。佢而家就會俾阿 Vettel 俾緊壓力佢，但係前面阿 Raikkonen 就唔知走咗去邊噶啦。咁前面嗰個已經係 Van Dorn 唔係 Raikkonen。咁嚟到第八個咧，我哋見到前面係有部 Sauber 嘅，咁係阿 Ericsson 嘅 Sauber 嘅。咁你抽咗阿 Ericsson 嘅内弯，但系佢 lock 咗胎，咁就俾一个好好嘅机会我哋爬头嘅，但系佢第二个弯就会冲咗出嚟，掉开咗就搞到我哋冇咗个分 wing 啦。咁我哋亦都俾后面推咗下个车尾线一线。咁但系因为我哋已经入咗 P 嘅关系，我哋已经唔可以换呢个分 wing 噶啦，因为绝对会输好多时间嘅。咁我哋被迫要咁样 keep 住啊后面而家 Verstappen 啦，后面一个车团翻嚟嘅。咁我哋絕對係會比後面慢嘅，因為我哋冇咗嘅彎速啦。咁我哋會開埋 DLS 咧，再次攻擊呢個 Ericsson 嘅，會喺呢個 Ascari 抽佢左邊，但係佢攝咗落個 Apex 度，仲要 lock 咗胎，搞到佢而家其實好慢，拍咗車咁闊。咁變咗我哋又冇咗一個機會去爬 Ericsson 啦。後面 Verstappen 嗰邊已經我哋後面見到後面有部車抽咗嚟，嗰部係夏美頓嘅 Benz 嘅。咁我盡力就 keep 住阿 Verstappen 會喺阿。夏美頓前面咧，咁嚟到後尾彎呢個 parabolica 咧，我哋直接 die form 咗 Ericsson 嘅，唔可以俾佢再阻住我哋嘅。咁而家 Ericsson 就會阻住 Verstappen 佢哋，但係阻唔到好耐嘅，咁就已經俾佢哋排咗頭啦。咁我哋而家嚟到第十個 lap 啦，後面會係 battle 嘅。 咁 Vettel 佢而家会喺呢个 back straight 嗰度咧抽咗我哋嘅右边啦，我哋尽力守啊 Vettel 啦，但系始终我哋 Les 冇出弯，冇呢个速度，原本已经唔够嘅 downforce 再加埋一个烂咗嘅分圈嘅话，其实我哋系好难 keep 到 Vettel 喺后面嘅。你见到 Ascari 佢甩咗我哋几多就知，其实系唔掂嘅。咁系啦，嚟到第十一个 lap 啦，后面系阿咸美顿噶啦，咁佢就会咧。有 DRS 啦，呢個距離有 DRS 啱呢個 slipstream 嘅話，我哋要防佢咧就係好難嘅，但係點都要防噶啦。咁嚟到 pump straight 嗰度咧，佢爬太早咧，咁我哋會食個氣流，然之後嚟個 lay break 嘅，衝入個內彎度夾硬 keep 阿咸美頓喺度，然之後喺個起油位咧就做啲好少少嘅起油啦 ，keep 住阿咸美頓喺後面啦，係有啲夾硬嚟嘅，我知係有啲夾硬嚟嘅，但係我講咗噶啦，你偷咗 Raikkonen 個 win 咧。我就會搞死你，就算不是現實搞死你，我這裡都要搞死你。咁嚟到 lap 12啦，咁係我最怕嘅地方啊 ！Les 冇二出嚟，我哋係冇呢個 power 嘅，咁我哋夾硬 keep 住阿夏美頓喺後面係 keep 唔到噶啦。咁喺 breaking point 冇計，如果我 lay break 嘅話，呢我絕對會衝出去嘅。咁你見到夏美頓其實已經走咗噶啦，咁係我做到嘢係咁多噶啦。因為沒有個分位，因為 Ericsson 的關係，我們 keep 不到夏美頓後面，我們都拿不到一個 podium。 那第13個 lap， 拉著一個 lap， 我試一下在頭彎這裡過他的，但是夏美頓沒有給到夠的位置我們，那也都甩了第二邊分位了。那後面不知道為什麼轉了 Hulkenberg 和 Verstappen， 但我不理那麼多了。咁我而家最緊要就係爬翻夏美頓，過咗 Curve Grande 嚟到第二個 Chicane 嘅時候，繼續打試下衝入個內彎，但係始終個距離係唔夠嘅。咁似乎我嘅攻勢係真係去到呢度完啦。咁係啦，嚟到最尾一個彎出翻嚟，我哋會第四名翻到嚟嘅。Podium 會有 Raikkonen、Vettel， 然之後夏美頓，我哋會喺第四名啱啱好上到去。
Ferrari into Parc Fermé. What a fantastic race it was. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Here come our winning drivers then, out onto the podium at the end of a thrilling Grand Prix. The drama and excitement are over, and it's time to let it all sink in. Congratulations to our top three today. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. It's a good result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. Moving on to the driver of the day then, Anthony Davidson, who would you go for?
I'm going to say Brendan Hartley. It was probably one of his best drives this season, and I was thoroughly impressed.
On to the constructors then. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. After all that excitement, it's time for a lie down, I think.Thanks for joining us and goodbye until the next race.
咁今次 F1 2018去到呢个位置先啦，好多谢留到最后，我先问先，拜拜。